Manost here with Dan the Outlaw Hardy. We just wrapped up UFC Fight Night 109 weigh-ins, and we're going to have a brief chat with Dan the Man about the fighters on the card and what we can expect from it. Dan, tell us what do you think about the fight card in general, and what do you think on the fighters coming from the Balkan region that are fighting tomorrow night?
I'm excited to see both of them. I think there are a lot of talented fighters coming out of that region. Obviously, the ones that we've seen in the UFC so far have done excellent work. I think Bojan Veličković is a very exciting fighter. He's dynamic. He's never been stopped within the distance. So you know he's tough. He only loses by decision. And he's got a lot of experience. I think he's, 28 years old? And he's had, 18 fights. It's a lot of experience for a young man. So he comes into the UFC with a well-thought-out game. He knows what he's good at. He knows where his weaknesses are. Obviously, he's moved to Colorado to the Elevation Fight team, and he's got great guys around him, great coaches, and good inspiration for a young man who's, you know, just starting out in the UFC and has a lot of potential in a very, very busy division.
From fighters coming from the region, we had a lot. We have the legacy of Mirko Krokop, especially, and people like Igor Pokrajac, and a lot of the guys who haven't been or are yet to come in to the UFC. What do you think about those guys, up-and-coming guys and the established ones?
Well, the established guys have already shown that they're very, very good. Obviously, the names that you mentioned, I mean, Krokop's an absolute legend, was always one of my favorite fighters. And I was fortunate enough to call his fight against Gonzaga. And I think you can hear on the microphone how excited I was for that fight. With me being left-footed and the left high kick, me being my weapon, I was very inspired by him. Igor Pokrajac came back to the UFC for one fight and looked like one of the toughest people that we've ever seen on the roster. But what we're seeing now with these new kids that are coming through, guys like Demir and Bojan, they're much more of a mixed martial artist. Instead of a martial artist from a traditional background that's trying to learn mixed martial arts, they are mixed martial artists from the very beginning. So we see, we're seeing knockouts as well as submissions on their record, which it's promising because it shows development in the area. It shows that mixed martial arts is growing around the world, and every region's being touched by mixed martial arts. You know, there's inspiration from some of the greatest fighters in the world, and now obviously with the UFC being an international organization, we're looking at all these other regions to pull fighters in because we don't know what they have to offer. You know, that's the beautiful thing about martial arts. You know, you go to Holland and you get great kickboxers. You go to Japan, you get crazy grapplers. You go to America, you've got strong wrestlers. So now we're starting to move into these smaller areas around Europe. Every region that we go to offers something new. But ultimately, we're seeing mixed martial artists from every region, and that's what we need to see. We need to see progress, and the new guys coming out of that region are definitely showing us that.
You mentioned or teased your fans about the potential comeback fight. One last hurrah. No title aspirations on your end, but you would like to fight a name, as you said. Mm-hmm. Tell us a little bit more about that, about the health issues you faced and overcame, and where are you at now, and who would you like to fight, maybe?
Well, my health issues are resolved. It was more of a confusion on the side of the US doctors. They very much felt like I needed a surgery in order to continue competing. I was convinced I didn't need to, so I went to see other specialists, and I have documented tests now to prove that I'm healthy to fight. So now the next stage, obviously, is the USADA testing pool. I have to be reintroduced to the UFC roster. I'm still under contract. I still have 3 fights on my record. I doubt I will have 3 fights. I may only have 1. But what's nice for me now is that I've, over these last kind of 4.5 years, I've stepped back away from the sport and I've become very much a fan again. And I think people will see from my analyst work, I obsess about the fighters. I want to learn everything that they do. So to be able to have learned so much over these last few years and to be able to step back in and see if I'm better as a fighter, I certainly feel like I am. I certainly feel like I'm a lot smarter than I used to be. Not quite as reckless, perhaps, and far more precise with my striking than I used to be as well. I was good at a few things before, and there were lots of holes in my game, and I feel like I've closed some of those holes. So ultimately, if I was to come back, I want an opponent that is going to be an exciting fight, someone that's not thinking about a future title shot because they're the guys that fight kind of safe and they don't take the risks that I would like to take in a fight. You know, it's less about winning for me and more about exploring the martial arts. And sometimes you come out on the wrong end of it. And I think there are a lot of good guys out there, guys like, obviously, you know, Cowboy and Sanchez and Gilbert Melendez, you know, all these guys that are kind of towards the end of their career that maybe not thinking about moving back into the title picture, that would be a great test for me. They have excellent martial arts in every range, and that's ultimately what I want to test me. And for me, more than anything, I need to feel like I'm going to get excited about the fight. So that's the test for me. If the UFC call me up and say, hey, what about this guy? If immediately my heart races and I get excited, that's a good opponent. And there aren't many guys in the UFC that would do that for me right now, because I'm much more of an analyst and looking in as a fan. And I enjoy this position that I'm at. And I also feel like I serve the sport better in this position as well. So when the time comes, the right opponent will present itself. And if I could fight in New York, I would love to. If I could fight in the Saitama Super Arena in Japan, I would love to. Obviously, being back in London would be great as well. But for me, it's more about the experience of being in there and having a great fight for the fans.
We certainly hope to get to see you fight at least one more time. A few more questions. Let me know, which fight are you most excited about that's going to happen tomorrow?
That's a very difficult question, because I change my mind every 5 minutes. I'm very excited to see Darren Till against Yessen Ayari. I was picking that as fight of the night, but obviously now with Darren Till missing the weight, that makes me concerned about how his performance is going to be, whether he's going to be able to fight as hard as he normally does. And obviously Yessen Ayari is a great fighter over 3 rounds, so he's going to be tough all the way through to the fight. The other kid I'm really excited about is Abdul Razak Al-Hassan. He's a scary individual. He's had 7 fights, 7 knockouts, all in the first round. I think his longest fight's about 1:30. And he's fighting Omari Akhmadov, who's one of the toughest, most difficult to handle individuals in the sport. He's very, very strong. He's very much an in-your-face kind of striker. He likes to push the pace. He takes big risks. And against Al-Hassan, who's got power in both hands, it's going to be an explosive fight. I think both guys are very aggressive and very much here for a fight and not here for thinking about their win column and their record. But then I think the sleeper of the night is possibly Trevor Smith against Chris Camozzi. You know, Trevor Smith's a very, very tough wrestler. He's a real grinder. And I don't think we've seen the best performance out of him yet. I still think he has a lot more to offer. And with him being a strong wrestler with a good top game and good ground and pound, matching up against Chris Camozzi, who is a great grappler, you know, and we've not seen much of his grappling because he's been matched up against guys like Jacare. And you can never really show how good you are at grappling when you're in there against the best. So for these two guys to tussle on the floor, I think it's going to be a very evenly matched fight. I think they'll both take a lot of punches, and I think they'll both continuously attack on the floor. I think that'll be a fun one.
And one last thing, who do you think is the number one prospect out of the UFC and in the UFC, up and comer?
I think there are a few. I think, the one guy that was on this card that has been pulled out with a shoulder injury, Mirbak Taisimov, I'm very, very excited about him. I think he looks like a little George St. Pierre. I think he's very, very physically well-balanced. He moves very well. Obviously, he's a very ferocious fighter. He's got a good wrestling background, as well as spending a lot of time with Roger Huerta at Tiger Muay Thai. My other favorite at the moment is Thomas Almeida. You know, he had that one loss on his record, but other than that, he's looked amazing. And the only time we've really seen him in any trouble apart from his loss was in the Brad Pickett fight, where he got hurt early on, but then was able to rally and come back and get the finish. I think, for me, in my opinion, I think he's the next stage of the Shootbox team. I think we saw Vanderlei and Shogun and all the old guys from Shootbox that are aggressive fighters with good Muay Thai, but they're more aggressive than technical. Thomas Almeida is the next stage on from that. He's aggressive as well as being very technical. So I think he's another one to watch. And he's so young that we've still got a lot of time for him to develop.
Dan, thanks a lot for taking the time. Mm-hmm.